Welcome back to Let's Play Scratches, Director's Cut. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, and, well, we missed the electrician. We looked around for candles and could not find any. And then we were gonna go to the store to get candles, but our car is dead. So, we were not meant to have light. That's plain to see. Well, there goes the crowning glory of my troubled first day. The car won't start. That cursed fog is the culprit. I forgot and left the lights on, and of course, I have been too busy to bother with the car. I should ask Jerry to come for me. Alright. Let's ask Jerry to come for us. I don't think he will.
Ding. Jerry, you won't believe this. It's insane. My car is dead.
What? Are you sure? Have you checked its pulse?
Very funny.
I'm not joking. It's gone.
My friend, this completely redefines the term suspension of disbelief you sometimes use for your stories.
I know. I'm speechless. I forgot the lights on and the car ran out of batteries. All because of that bloody fog. Jerry, you've got to help me. Get over here.
Michael, look at the time. I can't drive to Northumberland right now.
But, Jerry, I can't spend the whole night without one single source of light. I barely know this place, and I won't be able to find my way. Heck, I don't even know if it's rid of ghosts yet.
Are you a sleepwalker, Michael? You lie down on the bed, you sleep, you wake up, and you'll have tons of bright light then.
That's not helping. And you're the one who got me into this mess in the first place.
Well, if you have to use the bathroom.
Hold on a minute. If the electrician missed you for a few minutes, there aren't any candles in a three-story mansion, and your car's battery was low.
It's okay. All your fault.
Okay, listen. When will you be coming back to Rothbury?
I'll be arriving home early tomorrow morning, and I'll come for you shortly after. We'll drive to town, stock yourself up, and then spend the rest of the day in your garden drinking some beers while we wait for Mr. Electrician. Sounds like a plan?
Yeah, I guess. And I don't think there's any plan B either.
Afraid not. Sorry. I really took all the precautions to make your stay there as comfortable as possible. But I guess sometimes things are just meant to go wrong.
Yeah.
Apparently. All right. I'll be on my way then.
Call me back if you need anything. And Michael?
Yes?
Yeah?
Don't let this situation get on your nerves.
Too late.
I promise it won't. Goodbye.
Too late, I tell you. Too late. Let me guess, busy? Yep. I'm sure we don't need to talk to Barbara. Okay. Alright, well, if we head upstairs, we can go check the, what do you call it? Let's see if we can check out those newspapers. Jerry won't be able to drive today. I'm on my own, alone. No lights, and I don't even know the house yet. I did know what I was getting into by coming here, but this isn't what I was expecting. Going up. I have to go. Oh. Okay. Oops. Ah! I looked for the date that Jerry told me and found an interesting article. The Journal, Northumberland Daily Newspaper, Tuesday, 25th May, 1963. Terrible news shocks the community of Rothbury. Mr. James Blackwood, distinguished resident of the town and a widely acknowledged construction engineer, was accused of murder yesterday by Miss Eva Mariani, maid of the Blackwood family. Oh. While the nature of this situation is of the most unusual, given that Mr. Blackwood is a highly respected gentleman, Miss Mariani, an Italian immigrant and aspiring photographer, affirms having a photograph that supports this accusation. So that's that room downstairs. Must be the maid's room. Did I hear creaking? I thought I heard creaking. Right. Because she's got the photographs, the books on photography. Yeah, she's got the camera in one of the dressers. And she made the tub into like an exposure photo lab, I guess you'd call it. The funny thing is, there's no curtains on the windows to black out. You know, it's not a black room. So, I don't know how she's... Doesn't it need to be a black room? So she... Oh, and an Italian immigrant. Okay, so the letter was written... That's why in Italian was written by Miss Mariani, the maid. Makes sense. I know no one would ever believe me, so I took a picture of him, she says. I was supposed to be in town during the afternoon, but I didn't have the need to... I mean, I didn't have any errands to do. So I was in my room and saw this shadow out in the garden. Didn't have the need... I was supposed to be in town. I didn't have the need to. The need to what? She cuts off. Interesting. When I glanced through the window, I just couldn't believe my eyes. The lady... Oh, God, the sole thought of it sends shivers down my spine. The photograph in question is in possession of the authorities, and it has been revealed that it clearly shows Mr. Blackwood bearing a shape in his garden. We can almost confirm that the shape is a body, says Police Chief William Bailey. But even if the image is not clear, this alone with Miss Mariani's statement, is enough to open a serious case against Mr. Blackwood. Police officers are already heading to the Blackwood Manor as we speak. Up until this accusation, it was believed that Mrs. Catherine Blackwood was on a trip. According to the information we received from the school where she teaches, the police chief continues, a notice was sent to the teacher's department which stated that Mrs. Blackwood had to leave on a sudden trip and that she would make use of her license to do so. Miss Mariani's accusation puts Mr. Blackwood in a very compromising situation. Even if we can't find anything in the garden, he has a lot of explaining to do. Huh. I wonder if we can find something in the garden. Because... That would be unlikely, though, because they've already obviously been through there. And if they found anything, it's been removed. And if they couldn't find anything, then how am I gonna find something? Right? We're a novelist, not a forensic team. The efforts of Dr. Christopher Milton, one of Rothbury's most respected doctors and longtime friend of the Blackwood family. Well, that's what... He stayed here, too, right? To minimize the facts have been unsuccessful, and the news is the subject of discussion throughout the whole town. Hundreds of rumors are crossing the land. Theories range from plausible and well-conceived to wild and crackpot ideas. But the question that keeps lingering in everybody's mind... for which the answer has yet to be found, is why would a wealthy and educated man cold-heartedly murder his wife after 30 years of marriage? It was the voices. The voices made him do it. He was hearing voices. So, that letter that we found in the bedroom prepared for us in the waste bin, I think would be the English term for it, the waste bin, the rubbish bin. I guess, was that written after he killed her? I can go check, see if there's any, like, reference to him doing a dark deed. So, the photograph bearing a shape in his garden. Miss Catherine Blackwood. Dr. Christopher Milton. So each pile shows me the same thing. May 25th. January 1970, though. This was like, well, almost 3 years later. Just checking to make sure he didn't, you know, sell her as meat to these meat packers. Well, he's buying it, right? This is buying meat. Well, I never. Now what? Turn around, there's someone behind me. I want to check the paper. You know, the crumpled up note. It was getting late. Perhaps it was now a good time to go to sleep. Well, that's it for today. It wasn't exactly the first day I was expecting, but I'll get over it. In spite of everything, I'm looking forward to continuing the exploring of my incredible new home tomorrow. I found an article regarding the murder Jerry told me about. The situation was vague and left many queries. I wonder if Blackwood was wrongfully accused. I wasn't wondering that. I completely think he did it. Unless it wasn't him, but somebody else. I'm curious what time it actually is, so I have to check the clock for that. I was getting very tired. Okay, hint, hint. Oh, wrong stairs. Oops. I was getting very tired. The time was 7 p.m. It's not that late. Jeez. It must be in the middle of summer because otherwise light would not still be coming through these windows. Alright, I guess we're going to bed. I want to check that note. Yeah, yeah, very tired. I'm not gonna read all this again. I read it before. If you wanna read it, you can pause. Bar the doorway. I'm experiencing exactly what James did. Oh. So the doctor wrote this. I can only look at that. Oh, the thing on the wall says his name. Rothbury, but I can't read it. It's gotta be him, though. Christopher, what's his name? I guess we're going to bed. Did I ever try to look at those books? Probably nothing interesting. No. To sleep, perchance to dream, I laid down on the bed. Banging on this door? Or the door downstairs? The sound of a hammer banging away wouldn't let me sleep. That's the same picture. How could we even see? I want to check the front door first, but I have a feeling it'd be coming from upstairs. That's where all the work was being done. Oh, evidently I can't go downstairs. Okay. Oh. This looks different. Before the work was done. Before the... Dark. Yeah, I'm not liking this very much. Oops. Don't do that! No! I can't look at these things. Oh.
Michael.
I was awakened from my strange dream by some odd noises reverberating around the room. Are we still dreaming? The view is... still in there. Now I can go downstairs. How can we even see? I guess there must be a lot of moonlight. Creepy. I didn't want to leave the house at this time. It was already chilly enough inside. And spooky. What time is it? The time was 12 a.m. 12 midnight. What are we supposed to be doing? Calling somebody? I had no one to call at this time. I was awakened in the middle of the night by some strange sounds, like an obsessive scratching coming from somewhere deep in the house. I don't like this at all, and I should probably investigate. No, I would hide. Hide until daytime. Let me guess, it's coming from the basement. See anything different in here? I don't want to go in the basement. It's creepy enough during the day. Did I look at this? Most of the clocks in the house weren't working. James T. Blackwood. The T is for Tiberius. No, not really. What about this, what he was writing? Does it have a date on when he was... February 6th, but what day? Yeah, I don't know. There's another one. Oops. How do I... Oh. That didn't appear at first. It's gotta be coming from the basement, even though we don't hear it anymore. I do hear weird bells. April 20th. More options. Coming from the next room. I often wonder what would have happened if we had simply reversed it all. What would happen if right now I came out and told the world what really happened? No, I'd end up rotting in jail. Although that might be better... a better destiny compared to this eternal suffering. I wonder if he's referring to killing his wife at that point. If he had told the world what really happened. So maybe he wasn't put in jail. Well, perhaps James was right after all. So this isn't written from James. This is written by the doctor, then. Everything James suffered was a misfortune. If I had acted in another way, then maybe things would have worked out differently. The noises are back. I can really feel them spreading around the house. The noises are coming from down there. I don't want to think about it anymore. They get worse at night. What's going on down there? I don't dare go near her. I don't want to know. Did you ever leave this place, Doctor? I have a feeling you didn't. Well, I don't like this, but I'm pretty sure I was supposed to be going to the basement. Let's see if we hear the noises again as we get closer. I'm not hearing anything. Did these open? Did I open these? The drawer was stuck beyond hope. Well, really close to the basement, yet I don't hear the noises. I really don't want to go in there. Or down there. Or anywhere near there, really. I thought about investigating, but then I realized the basement would be pitch black at this time. I couldn't go down there without some light. Okay. Does that mean we're not going down there? Does that mean we're gonna find a way to light the lantern? Well, now we're gonna find a candle. That's not a candle. Sadly, I won't be able to investigate the sounds anymore. I can't proceed inside the basement without some light. I guess I'll have to cope with them for the time being. Oh. So we just go back upstairs then? This is a pointless exercise. Plus, I stopped hearing the noises. Wouldn't they get louder? Not go away. Well, we can go up here. Shall we go up here? I want to go up those stairs. We can hear the noises again. Only in this room. Yet the noises don't come from this room. Not until I figured out where the scratching noises were coming from. But you just said we can. Am I supposed to find a light? Doesn't have oil. Can I bang on the floor to tell him to shut the hell up? I mean, I've already looked around for stuff. I didn't find any candles. I didn't find any lamp oil. Should I check the African room? Well, African museum room? Because that was different in our dream. The lamp seemed to be broken beyond repair, probably the souvenir of a hazardous journey. Trying to get light. There's something special about those. Maybe I can sleep in this room. Since we don't hear the noises from here, right? Too fancy. But it's peace and quiet. We only hear the noise in that room. Is there a vent or something in this room? We can't just put, it's gotta be an activatable thing. Maybe here, the noises seem to grow louder as I approach the fireplace. I listened carefully as I moved the stethoscope around the fireplace. Yes, the noises were coming from there, but I still couldn't determine their source. Now what? Should we dig it? Dig it up? What's this key? Rusty golden key. Clean it off, maybe? Something underneath? Clean enough? I doubt it. It's covered with soot. Matches? I am a pyromaniac, mister. Listen again. Well, I don't have anything else unless I put this. Wait. Didn't need to do that. Figure I'd light it. I have no idea. It comes from here. So what do we do about it? Not until I figured out where those scratching noises were coming from. Well, we figured it out. I keep thinking, what if I burn something in the fireplace? But I'm not allowed to do that. I was thinking, use this to break through the bricks. The knife. What others can you do with a fireplace? And dig it up. Light something. Alright. I'm gonna call in an episode here, guys, because we've been running long and I don't know what to do. So thanks so much for watching, see you next time, and always, seek adventure.